Hello, fam, and thank you for coming back. It's 4:11 p.m. Eastern Standard Time Zone in the ATL. And we're relaxing. We're cooking. We're relaxing. We're doing this video. We're washing. And I'm going to soon be eating in a few minutes. But I just had to come by and talk with you all about Nene calling herself. She don't believe she going to return to the Real Housewives of Atlanta. I'm like, Nene, how many times we done heard that girl? Make it make sense. Go on out there and do your thing. If you're going to be on a talk show, go on and tell folks. I know Sharon Osbourne over there, the Satanist herself. But anyway, she's over there. She loving on herself. So, Nene. Yes, Nene is climbing those ladders. How you say climbing up Jacob's ladder? But it's not Jacob's ladder, honey. She climbing up there trying to stomp with the big dogs. And I'm not talking about in my Martin voice, okay? I'm talking about that satanic realm, okay? It's plenty levels to where you got to be to make it in Hollywood, Hollyweird, okay? And Bethany, Sharon Osbourne, Wendy Williams, Oprah Winfrey. Who else have we been seeing Nene rub heads with? Vanderpump. Yes, all of them are in that realm. Hell, I say the Kardashian family, Kris Jenner. Okay? And Nene be sporting their wear. Okay? Their Egyptian wear. As well as throwing up them hand signs in her body formation. Check her out, okay? And go back and do your research when I told you about these hand signs. So you can quietly be educated on what's going on, how they doing it with this, that, and the third, and how they gently, you know, cross over messing with their hair, and you think they just doing it for the camera. No, honey. Kenya does a lot of that. But no, those are signs and giving homage to who they really serve. But we're gonna go into an article that Todd Mame had wrote out for Celebrity Insider. He's a little correspondent or a journalist over there putting out salacious articles of gossip entertainment for us to partake of. And I want to say thank you. Thank you to him for giving me something to talk about and putting my spin, my opinions, my perspectives on what I feel about what was said in his article. Okay, but I want to give a warm thank you, lots of hugs and kisses to people that dropped by the house and wanted to sit there and make their opinions known. Do your thing, do your thing, and tell other people to come on over to the family. I would love for y'all to subscribe and get in them comments every time I drop a video. That's what family's all about, you know what I'm saying? Helping and supporting one another. Yes. And like I said, we had some newcomers to the house, and I just want to acknowledge them and show love. Y'all show love to them as well. Be nice in them comments. That's the way, I mean, y'all be nice to them and be well with them, okay? We got Clarissa Gaffney. She stopped by. Foodie 2019, okay? If I had to stumble or stamp her on your name, because I'm trying to get it straight, but I'm going to say like foodie 2019. If I'm wrong, let me know in the comments. Other than that, love and kisses on you, my dear. Okay, then we got Don St. Okay, we got Tori the Turtle out there talking and saying this, that, and the third. We got Plain Trina out there. We got D Prince from Hawaii. Hello, Hawaii. Aloha. I think that means hello. And aloha, that means goodbye in a Hawaii language. Okay, what does it say? How do you say see you later? Is that Hawaii? Is that aloha as well? My little D Prince out there. I can see you already now doing that little belly dance going on and, you know, just caressing my atmosphere, my demeanor, and just letting me feel like I'm on the waves of sitting on Hawaii's cliffs and just watching the waves crash and just giving me so much serenity. Welcome, girl. Welcome, D. Welcome, D Prince, all the way from Hawaii. Yes, family, she came to see us cut up and talk about this, that, and the third. Okay, we're going to give it to her, and I hope she subscribes to the channel and come back often, as in every time I drop a video. Get down in them comments, tell me, ooh, I'm here, Dale. And I'll be like, hey, D Prince, and the rest of my family. Yes, I will. And thank you, is it Kayanne Wilson? Hello, hello, blessings to you all. And let's get down into this funky, funky mess. Okay, they give us as a salacious story. Okay, but like I said, it was Todd. Mame, giving us the story on saying Nene Leakes explains why she likely won't come back to Real Housewives of Atlanta. Now, we're going to emphasize on that word likely because we don't know. But if she don't come back, rest assured she's been appointed to a higher position. You never know, hon. She might be sitting up there having her own talk show. Now, wouldn't Candy Burris be mad about that shit? Now, wouldn't she be mad? But she's in that same realm. But you know how you get discord in just a regular realm of living, honey. They have discord up there in the satanic realm as well. You want to have people on top. You want to know how they got there, what did they do, and this, that, and third, when all of them are serving the same man. Master, okay, and that's Satan himself. But of course, when you got chaos and all that, you're gonna have discord. You're gonna have nothing but discord. Ain't no peace gonna be there. Everybody gonna always try to trample on the other one to get to that next level. But that's just how they get down. But that's my sidebar, not in this man's article. Let's go on and see what he had to say in his article. Okay, y'all. Okay, fam, can we do it? But I guess I forgot to say, how y'all doing this Sunday? How y'all doing this Sunday afternoon? We're creeping mighty close to his time of airtime when we see the Real Housewives of Atlanta and Mark get into Kenya, or Kenya get into Nene, or Nene get into Candy. I don't know how it's gonna go, but we're gonna be right there, right? Okay, so make sure you got your beverage of choice, you done laid back, saw the review, and then we coming in as a family. I'm gonna give you the synopsis of what I saw and what I felt, and then again you're gonna get in them comments and tell me what you thought. That's what we do, give and take over here, take and give. And I want to say a special hello to Miss Anna Banana. You know I'm going to always keep throwing love on you. Don't know what you're feeling like. Don't know what you're doing. But hopefully you're relaxing. And you know trouble don't last for always. And the medication that you were telling me about, that clonopin, it's kind of good. But you've been on it for 20 years, my dear. You might need to switch on something else. Okay? I'm just saying, giving you much love. Because I was on one before and I had to try out another one. Because sometimes it gets so in your bloodstream to where it gets numb to the effects it's trying to help. You understand what I'm saying? It's just like taking Tylenol for so many things and then it just don't work. You need something else. Now that's just my advice to you. Take it or leave it, but you know I love you and I will always continue to pray for you. And that's for Anna Banana. Okay, and that's for anybody else that's taking medication out there. It seems like it's not doing something for you that it used to do. Go and talk to your primary care physician about it. They can definitely switch you on something else, get that perkiness back in you, and so you can succeed, be well, go forth, and be great. Now, that's what I got to say, and that's what I'm saying. And we're going to move on into this article where it says, during her appearance on the talk. Yes, the talk. I'm sure y'all saw her. I didn't really see it, but I heard about it. Got little short clips, videos. But Sharon Osbourne was loving on herself. Some Nene Leakes. She even said, that nasty girl. You know who that nasty girl she was talking about? Girl, she was talking about Kenya Moore. Just in case you didn't hear it. Yes, Lord. It's kind of a blurry picture. I'm trying to figure out why she went to from brunette and burgundy to straight up silver. Is that a new thing they're doing over there in their club? I'm just saying, because you know the spit gate is supposed to come out and we're gonna see what's going on with that issue. Okay, because I thought we had put it to rest, but I guess it's gonna come out for full circle where we can get some more edification on it. Not in that man's article, just my sidebar. You know I do it from time to time. Okay, but going back into the article, it says during her appearance on the talk on the 19th of February, the Real Housewives of Atlanta star Nene Leakes shared why she has reservations about signing on for another season for the aforementioned reality television show. My sidebar, Nene, if you ain't got nothing else in the works, go on and make your money, girl, because you know you don't want to go out there and work hard, and you got to support those other swag boutiques and other things you got going on, honey. Don't let the well dry up. Don't always miss that well when it done dried up, child, because when it's gone, it's gone. My sidebar, not in the article. We go back, it says BET reported that Nene, who first started on the series back in 2008, spoke with the host of the talk show and explained that she felt as though Real Housewives of Atlanta was her baby because she started on it over 10 years ago and played a crucial role in its popularity. Okay, yes you did, but what about the other players in the game, Nene? Don't forget them. They help you. You tape with them. Don't throw them out. Okay, that's just my sidebar, not in this article. Going back to the article, it said, with that said, Nene argued that she didn't want to star on a reality television series where all the cast members are continuously attacking each other with malicious intent. Sharon Osbourne, you know that's Ozzy Osbourne, the rock star, the satanic rock star, all that kind of stuff. Yes, that's his wife, Sharon Osbourne. Okay, going back to the article, just had to give you the edification in case you didn't know. All right, look up Ozzy Osbourne if you want to, and you can find out what type of lifestyle he got down in. Okay, but he's suffering from depression and some dementia and some other stuff going on with him, but let's keep him in prayer as well. Okay, prayer changes everything. It can get you out the satanic realm if you want it. Okay, but anyway, going back to the article, it says Sharon Osbourne, while stoking the flames of the Real Housewives of Atlanta feud, told Nene she thought a nasty girl was jealous of her. Ooh, we going back to elementary and high school when we started nasty girls. What are they talking about? Think I'm a nasty girl. Nasty girl. Nasty girl. Do you think I'm a nasty girl? You remember them girls? I forgot what their name was, but I think they were part of Rick James group or something like that. Or was it Prince? I think it was the Mary Jane girl. You can be my candy man. Yeah. Woohoo. Woohoo. And I'll flip the script on the two songs. But that's just how I roll, child. That's how I roll, children. But anyway, yeah, I think they were the candy girls. But anyway, that's where she said it was a nasty girl, and she was talking about Kenya Moore. Without Nene, Sharon argued there simply wasn't a show. Okay, according to Lee, she had to watch the other episodes first and also has to make sure that nasty girl won't be saying mean things that she shouldn't be saying. According to BET, the nasty girl is referring to Nene's co-star Kenya Moore. The outlet explained that much of season 12 has been very dramatic for Nene, who has fought with other women while also trying to repair her damaged friendship with Cynthia Bailey, who was once her best friend. Okay, we ain't gonna go too much into that because we know Nene tied up and then she sit back down with the same people she broke bread with and trying to build them back up after she done tore them down. And we know how Nene get down. It's all about her. She gotta have the attention, and that's where it has been since the inception of Real Housewives of Atlanta. Get into it. Now, sidebar, not in this man's article. It goes, yesterday, Ricky Mathers reported on comments made by Nene Leakes, including when she accused Kenya Moore of having a stank attitude. Nene stated that Kenya's attitude and disposition towards others would be the end of the series if she kept it up. Leakes argued that Kenya is always telling her that no one likes her, but in actuality, no one likes her, okay, regarding what she intends to do in the future. Nene has a variety of entrepreneurial endeavors she's been working on over the years. It goes without saying that Nene will surely find something else to do once she finally leaves Real Housewives of Atlanta. Now, I agree solely with that, because Nene has definitely been on a tour where she's going to ET Entertainment. She went to The View. She's been to The Talk. She's been making her whole circuit of talking with different heavy hitter platforms where she's getting out. But see, nobody's really talking about what Nene, and Nene's not giving that much. That's why I say she need Real Housewives of Atlanta as well, because she's, I don't think she's talking about and going to these different interviews outlets. You're just talking about the show and everything that's surrounding the show, about her leaving and this lawsuit she got going on, which we don't know who is really geared to. We just heard the word Lisa Bloom. She's on her team. I don't know if that was a threat or whatnot, but it just is what it is. But yeah, Steve Harvey doing the hand signs. We know how Anderson Cooper get down as well, but it just is what it is. If you believe in a secret society type of historian type archive out there, or you don't. You know, you believe in good and you don't believe it's bad out there. They both go hand in hand. All right, check into it. But we got this little clip I think we're going to play of the interview she was up there doing with the Talk girls on their platform, doing celebrity entertainment gossip and giving their spiel on it. Okay, hopefully it will play without buffering.
I'm gonna tell you that. that, you know, as far as coming back, I feel like this show is my baby. I started the show, but I also feel like I don't want to be in a group where I feel like everybody's attacking and being very malicious.
Well, I think that nasty girl is jealous of you.
Nasty girl!
And that's like Marie Osmond. Telling how she has the best heart.
You know, every season when the show ends, what me and my team do is we get together and we talk about what's best for me. So hopefully Real Housewives is best for me. I don't know.
Well, let's hope so.
Still undecided.
You're very undecided. Okay. I mean, that's the show is still going on. Yeah. And I have to finish watching the last 9 episodes to make sure that nasty girl is staying in her place and not saying things that she shouldn't be saying.
Do you think she's a nasty girl? Nasty girl. Nasty girl. Do you think Kia's a nasty girl? Okay, that's all I had to say about this particular article. That's all I got to say about this particular video. But you all are very intelligent. You all are very smart. You can all come up with your own conclusions about what's going to happen, what's not going to happen. All of it's just innuendos and speculations, okay? We'll know when they let us know, pretty much. And then we go and talk about it like we do every day on our family channel. Yes, Def Chanel's 4 Days, where we get down and we talk about celebrities, their comings and goings, or what they give us that we see on TV. Not that we speculating, going out there doing research, going out there seeing who they eating dinner with, lunch, breakfast, and then going through their trash. No, that's something we don't do. Whatever they tell us they do, we getting it from the news, or we getting it from the reality show program that we're watching them on. That's the only thing we got as per evidence over here at Def Chanel's World, because we just do talking, we do interacting, we just love on each other, we hope everybody's having a blessed and wonderful day, and then we just talk about different things that are trending out there on social media. That's what we do. So hey, y'all like this video, continue to share it with the masses. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please go on and subscribe and like, and I will see you all next video. Okay, take care. See you later.